of Group on Earth Observation, Secretary at GEO, Switzerland. Co-chairperson of the keynote session, Mr. Hirochimi Fuki of Kyo University, Japan. Chief guest, Mr. Charles F. Bolden, Jr., NASA Administrator. Mr. Michael Yeats, Senior Deputy Assistant Administrator of USAID. Distinguished high-level dignitaries from regional space agencies, SPARSO Bangladesh, CMA China, ISRO India, SUPARCO Pakistan, and JAXA Japan. Dr. Andreas Shield, Director General of the International Center for Integrated Mountain Development, ICIMOD. Mr. Basanta Sreshta, Division Head of Mountain Environmental Natural Resources Information System, MENRIS, of ICIMOD. Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, media friends, ICIMOD colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, welcome and namaste to all. I'm Naina Shakya, Fundraising and External Relations Officer at ICIMOD, and it is a great honor and privilege to serve as MC for this important event today. We are truly privileged by the presence of so many eminent personalities under this keynote session titled Regional and Global Initiative, Climate Change and Earth Observation. Before I give the floor to the chairperson to conduct the keynote session, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the chairperson, Professor José Ashaj, Director of GEO, who needs no further introduction. Professor Ashaj became the first director of the GEO Secretariat in 2005. Of French nationality, he has obtained a doctorate in geophysics as well as in physical sciences. Among his various accomplishments, as a prominent figure, he has been the director of the Graduate School of Earth Sciences and the French Geological Survey. He was also the Deputy Director General of the French Space Agency. Now, with much delight, I would also like to introduce the co-chairperson of this keynote session, Professor Hiromichi Fuki. He is a renowned professor at the Faculty of Policy Management under the Graduate School of Media and Governance at Kyoto University, Japan, by holding important positions as the director of the GIS Association. He was on the board of directors of the International Society for Digital Earth and the Center for Environment Information Sciences. To welcome the chairperson and co-chairperson, dear ladies and gentlemen, may we have a big round of applause. May I please request the chairperson to kindly conduct the keynote session.
Well, thank you very much for this kind introduction of the introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, welcome to this this first session, which will be opened by Dr. Andreas Shield. I don't know if it's really my role here in Kathmandu to introduce Dr. Shield, who is probably the most well-known person, well-known scientist in this area. Let me just say that Andreas Shield is a Swiss citizen, which makes him very close to me, because being French but living in Switzerland, I feel we're almost from the same country. So he was born in the Alpine mountains of Europe in Switzerland. And he's actually dedicated his whole career to development and international cooperations in mountain areas, and in particular to this other important alpine mountain, which is the Himalayas Hindu Kush chain. So he worked as a country director of Swiss Development Corporation in Nepal, and also in Rwanda, which is another kind of, well, not alpine, much older type of mountain. And worked as executive director of Intercorporation, which is a major Swiss NGO. And then he moved to this area and eventually became director of ICIMOD. He's been awarded the Sir Edmund Hillary Himalayan Environment Award, which is clearly a recognition by the government of India of the enormous work that Dr. Shield has dedicated 30 years of his career to the development in the Himalayan region. So with no further delay, Dr. Shield, the floor is yours.
Mr. Chairman, thank you very much for the very kind words. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, I'm very happy to welcome, of course, the administrator of NASA, Mr. Charles Bolden. I would like to acknowledge also the presence of very eminent representatives, of course, of the regional space agencies, then also from other NASA officials, Madam Chargé d'Affaires, the director of USAID Nepal. Welcome to this inauguration today. Ladies and gentlemen, dear participants, we had, I think, yesterday already a very good moment. Looking around last night, I had the impression that I was seeing a lot of smiling faces. The assessment of yesterday was positive, and I think what I heard from you is that what was particularly appreciated was the presence of youth. And I was very happy that my friend Dava Sherpa had a very good reaction in the public, and I think that is highly appreciated. Now, unfortunately myself, I was not present here, but I want to share with you I had also a good day, because the Minister of Environment and Forest of Government of India came to us, ICIMOD, and there were two things which were, I think, important also for today. Namely, he very clearly said, and he mentioned this also in the press conference, that India is considering ICIMOD as an anchor for regional cooperation in questions of adaptation to climate change. Now, what this means for the inauguration of this important program we are launching today is that we have a full cooperation and the direct interest of all the regional countries and stakeholders in the very important work. I think for us, it's creating a window of opportunity, and it is actually widening very substantially this window of opportunity. And there comes, of course, a second quote he was mentioning. He was saying explicitly, we, the government of India, are favoring and are supporting strongly regional cooperation based on strong national institutions. Now, I am sure, looking into the round and also thinking what our colleagues from China, from Pakistan, from Bangladesh are saying, I think we would all be sharing this opinion. We can play a very important regional role, provided we have committed and strong national institutions. What this means here for the program we are inaugurating today, that we can do, ICIMOD, can do the work and can be useful at regional level only provided we have very strong partners. We are very much aware that the title of the program, called Servir, which means serve, is a very high obligation for us. I think, thanks to the support of NASA, thanks to the support of USAID, we are going to be offered a very important instrument which has to be there, and we have to be able to use it for serving the stakeholders of the region. So that's the commitment we are taking over by benefiting from the launching of this program today. And I can promise you, we consider this as a very important and noble task, and I'm very happy to see you here, all attentive and ready to help you in this important endeavor. Now, I would like to conclude just by a remark. Yesterday I was mentioning the importance of bridging the gaps between the technology and the users, and emphasizing also the human face of this. Now, last night, sitting around the table with the administrator of NASA, We didn't discuss about satellites. We didn't discuss about high technology. But Mr. Bolden mentioned the research being done by NASA in relation with the human behavior in space. And how does it affect the people in the space, but also the body? So what we had as a discussion yesterday was not the technology, but the human face of space technology. And I'm very happy that the administrator of NASA is here with us, representing not just this top-notch technology, but also the human face of it. Mr. Bolden, we are very happy and very proud to have you in the Himalayas and to have you here. Thank you very much.